Saturday, September the 11th, 9/11 day. I'm going to celebrate my freedom by working in my garage on my engine, which I think is a good way of doing it. Right. God bless everybody that was hurt and impacted by what happened 20 years ago. I was actually stuck in Germany that week and was very grateful when I was able to get home a week and a bit later. Anyway, so clutch, a flywheel clutch and clutch housing day today. I have everything basically ready to go. My flywheel's cleaned up. Wow, this is heavy. These two dowels, they fit into the end of the crankshaft. So this is the crankshaft face. And and basically the clutch plate fits here. You see here it says gearbox side. We make sure that this is out, so this indent is towards the gearbox, not the other way around. And then this clutch plate housing fits onto these dowels, and you use this little device to line up the clutch plate splines relative to the end of the crankshaft so that we can engage the transmission correctly. It's fairly straightforward. Just do one piece at a time and should be good to go. So I have the engine at the top dead center and the flywheel has a B for the balancing mark on the outer edge. That's got to be at the bottom dead center when the flywheel is, when the engines at 1 and 6 are at top dead center. So this is going to be on the bottom dowel that allows me to position the flywheel relative to the crankshaft with respect to how it's balanced. So yeah. So the B mark is just there, and we're approximately at bottom dead center. So we have this the right way around. All right, the clutch assembly is on. These bolts on the outside are all tightened down. These are the dowel pins that locate it. Plate is fully compressed, and you can see the splines are concentric with this housing. So theoretically, it should all line up when I go to put the gearbox splines into that female spline. It's nice to get this far, looking like an engine. All right, with the clutch plate and on the flywheel, the next job is to put this thrust bearing in this bad boy here. This lever mechanism actually slides in here. I'll explain how that works once it's assembled, so I'm actually going to try and get that put in right now. Okay, so that clutch lever is installed. This is a carbon bearing, and when you press on your clutch, this whole assembly pushes forward, and that pushes on the clutch plate and housing, which relieves the tension on the clutch plate itself. And that disengages the drive from the flywheel to through the clutch plate into the transmission. So you disengage drive. So this is actually just moves up and back and forth. All right. One of the things I've got to do now is I've got to grease up the shaft, clean it up, make sure it's clean. It's come back great from Coventry West, but I need to tidy it up a little bit. And then this whole transmission is ready to slide on the engine. Can I have a go? Give me a minute here. So we're in the wrong dowel hole.
Yes.
Right, so we need to come out slightly.
Ever so slightly rails and bearings.
I need to. Let's do that. Right, just we don't want to come out all of the way.
Yep. I'm keeping my side and go up.
No.
We gotta rotate it towards you.
Right.
Alright.
Yep. There, I'm on my side.
Gearbox is on. It actually went on reasonably well. tried a couple of different things, but eventually put the engine on wood blocks to stabilize that, keep it still, and get it off the floor a little bit. Use the trolley jack to try and get the right height and alignment. This thing looks incredible. So happy with it. It's quite a significant moment right now. Had some great feedback about this crankcase breather, and I had it on the wrong way. I had it on the way that it was on the car, and it needs to be in this position. So I figured out how to do that, but I'll make that a topic for another video. And I got confirmation that my exhaust system is coming, so we'll be attaching the header. Looks very cool. It's a big moment right now.